Hello and good morning to all my lovely students. As you all know that we are doing our revisional topics, we have completed our course. So students, for today, 23rd of September 2020, the topic which we are going to undertake for our revision is dialogue writing. Okay students, so let us before moving ahead see what are some of the objectives of this particular topic. Number one is to get an insight about what a dialogue is. So we will recall back what a dialogue is, we'll try to understand it. And number two, to gain an understanding of writing a dialogue. Okay, so we'll also try to understand what are the important points to be kept in mind while tackling any writing of a dialogue. Okay, dialogue writing. And number three, to improve our creative thinking and writing skills. So as it is a writing thing, dialogue is a writing task, so when we write something, it automatically involves the thinking process, right? So when you try to write a good dialogue, it will improve your creative thinking and writing skills as well. So let's get started, students. First and foremost, let us see what a dialogue is. What is a dialogue? It is a written or spoken conversation between two or more people in a book, play or film. So, a dialogue can be a written or a spoken conversation between two or more people in a book. If a dialogue is in a book, it is a written conversation, right? Whereas if it is in a film, movies or plays, it is a spoken conversation. Basically, it is carried on between two people, or it can be with more than two person as well. Okay. Number two, the term dialogue originates from the Greek word dia, meaning through, and logos, which translates as word or meaning. So dialogue is a flow of meaning. So what happens? Dialogue originates from a Greek word dia, meaning through, and logos, which means as word or meaning. So in simple terms, dialogue is what? It is a flow of meaning. That means the conversation which goes on, there is a flow, there is a meaning in the conversation. Number three, it is an exchange of ideas or opinions between two or more people on a particular issue. So when a dialogue goes on, it is actually they are exchanging ideas or opinions between two or more people in a particular issue, on a particular issue, with a view to reaching an amicable agreement or settlement. So there is a particular topic on which they are talking. If it's a problem, they are trying to solve the particular problem and trying to come to an agreement or settlement. I hope you have understood what a dialogue is, right, students? So let us see some of the important points to be kept in mind while writing a dialogue. Before going ahead with that, let us see some of the types of dialogue writing, students. Let us see, there are basically two types of dialogue in literature. So which are those? Inner dialogue and outer dialogue. Let us try to understand what is an inner dialogue and what is an outer dialogue. Inner dialogue is, in an inner dialogue, the character speaks to themselves and reveal their personalities. So students, in movies or even in books, when we read, no, there are some characters which speaks to themselves, no, in different situations. So this type of dialogue is called as inner dialogue. And what is an outer dialogue? An outer dialogue, it is a simple conversation between two characters used in almost all types of fictional works. So an outer dialogue is what? It is a simple conversation between two characters we use basically in all types of fictional works. So basically we all are dealing with outer dialogue writing, right students? Now let us see some of the points to be kept in mind while writing a dialogue. Okay, while writing a dialogue, there are some important points to be kept in our mind. Number one, give names to the characters. Okay, so depending on your question, what you need to give names to your characters. If it is a male character, give male name. It is a female character, give female names. So your name should be apt to the characters. Number two, think about the situation to identify the points to include in the dialogue. So there's basically a topic given on which you need to write the dialogue, right, students? So what you need to do is you need to think about the situation, on which situation these two characters are going to exchange the dialogues. So after thinking the situation, you identify the points which you need to include in the dialogue, okay? Point number three, identify the main points that each character will speak about. So you already know the situation. After that, what you will think? You will identify these are the points that this character is going to speak. And my another character is going to reply back in this manner. And the other character is going to speak these few points. So it's an exchange of conversation, right? Exchange of opinions and ideas. So you need to be very clear when you sketch a dialogue that these are the points that my one character is going to speak and these are the points that the other character is going to speak. So when you sketch it out properly, when you give it properly, then your dialogue will have a logical flow. Ensure that there is a logical flow in the dialogue. So what it is, the flow of the dialogue should be very logical. For example, students, if I ask you, what is your name? Right? What the answer you would give me? You would say that my name is so and so. You will not say me that the time is 10 o'clock now. Right? Why? Because the question which I am asking you requires an answer based on your name. So when you write a dialogue, when one of your character is talking about a particular topic, the other character should also speak on that topic and in a very logical flow. Okay, there should not be any haphazard manner of conversation. And the last one is make use of all the necessary punctuation marks. So it is a dialogue, expression of your views and opinions. So there should be the use of punctuation marks. A lot of question marks, a lot of commas, a lot of inverted commas, right? A lot of exclamation marks you need to use while writing a dialogue. I remember that I have given you in your PT1 exam a dialogue writing. And most of you have written it well, but then many of you have forgotten to give the appropriate punctuation marks. So this will also carry some marks. Okay, so students, when you write a dialogue, please make use of all the necessary punctuation marks which are required. So number one is character, the names of the characters. Number two is the situation, the topic on which you are carrying out the dialogue. Number three is the main points which each character will be speaking. And number four, the logical flow of the dialogue. And number five, the use of necessary punctuation marks. So by now everything is clear. So let us see a simple example so as it will help you to write appropriate dialogue. Okay. So here is a dialogue between a sister and her younger brother about his first day of school. So what happens is the younger brother is Manish and the sister is Rachna. So the younger brother is quite reluctant going to school for the first time. All these days he was at home, so he doesn't want to go to school. But the elder sister Rachna, how she converses with him and then actually changes his mind to go to school. Okay, so let us see. As it is a dialogue between a sister and a younger brother, the name should be appropriate. A male name and a female name, right students? There you can see Manish is the younger brother name of a male character, Manish. And the way it is written, you can see the name of the person who is speaking the dialogue just after that colon is given, right? And then what Manish states. Rachna Didi, I don't want to go to school. I want to stay at home and play. So what Manish says that, I don't want to go to school. I want to stay at home and I want to play. Rachna, school is a lot of fun, Manish. You will make friends, learn new things and play a lot too. So Rachna is saying, trying to make Manish agree to go to school. She's saying that school is a lot of fun, Manish. You will make a lot of friends over there. You will learn new things and you can also play in school. Okay, Manish. really, I thought school was a scary place. So Manisha said, really, is it fun going to school? I thought school was really a boring place to be. Okay, let us see further. Rachna, school isn't scary once you make friends and know your teachers. So Rachna, the elder sister, is saying that school is not scary at all. Once you make friends and you know your teachers, there's a lot of fun, right? There are so many fun things to do on there too. So sister is saying that there are a lot of things to do there too, and it will be a lot of fun. So students, you can see the flow of the dialogue between Rachna and Manish, right? So how they are conversing, and you can also see the use of different punctuation marks as well here, right? Manish, what kind of interesting things? Can't I do these things at home? So Manish is again thinking, what kind of interesting things do we do at school? Can't I do that at home as well? So what is the response that Rachna gives? You will learn new things, play games, and do art and craft activities. So Rachna is saying, you will learn many new things. You will also play games and do art and craft activities. Okay, there are also school trips and sports days, which are so much fun. So Rachna is saying that there in school, you have school trips. You will go to school trips with a lot of your friends, like you all go, no? And learning out together with all your classmates. There are sport days when you, what do? You participate in different sport activities, right? So she's saying it is a lot of fun, and you can't do these things alone at home, no? Though you can play alone at home, you can't organize school trips and sports days at home. There will be art and craft activities as well. So after listening to all this, Manish says, okay, I will get ready for school. So it's a very small dialogue between two. One is a younger brother, between two person, a younger brother and an elder sister. How the younger brother was reluctant to go to school, but then the elder sister, with the conversation, that is with the dialogue, actually manages to send him and agrees, makes him agree to go to school. So I hope, students, you have understood. We have actually seen in today's class what a dialogue is. We have recalled back what is a dialogue. We have also seen, students, that there are two basic types of dialogue in English literature. That is inner dialogue, where the character speaks to himself or herself, and outer dialogue, which we are actually dealing with. That is a simple conversation between two people. And then we have also seen some of the important points to be kept in our mind while writing a dialogue. That is, we should name the characters, right, students? And also we should think about the topic or the situation on which we are writing the dialogue. We should think about the points which each characters will speak. And also we should think about the logical flow. And finally, we should use appropriate punctuation marks. So with this, we'll try to end our class here for today, students. I'll be assigning you your homework in the Google Classroom. So kindly do that. So in our next class, we'll be taking up another topic for our revision. So till then, students, take care, stay safe and healthy, and keep learning. Bye-bye.